So now that we have an idea of how we might use this data, let's actually build the maze from our plist and our JSON file. Now before we do that, if we go back to our plist file, I want to make sure everyone notices that the root of this plist file is a dictionary instead of an array. And this is also true of the JSON file because the first and the last characters are these curly braces, which are indicative of a JSON object, and a JSON object can be converted quite easily into a dictionary in Swift. Now the first thing we've done is define this enum called maze cell direction. And the most important thing about this enum is that its raw type is of int. And what this thing is going to allow us to do is it's giving us values 0, and then it's going to be 1, 2, and 3. And these will map to the indexes in these Boolean arrays. So instead of having to refer to the first element as the 0th element, we can use easier to read names like top, right, bottom, and left. So this is a little trick that I've used many a times. I'd recommend you to try it yourself. Then, as we said, both in the plist and the JSON file, these things are dictionaries. So we're going to start with a function that takes a dictionary, and we're going to return a string. And the string we're going to return is going to be really, really long, but it's going to be what allows us to visualize it here, as opposed to how we visualize it in the actual maze app. The first thing we want to do is make sure that the keys exist. So we need to have a row count, a column count, and cell data. And if we have all of those key value pairs, then let's make our maze string, our really, really long string representing the maze. Now this function here, the make maze string function, is where all the magic happens. The first thing we do is initialize a string called final string to the empty string. And then what we're going to do is we're going to loop through row by row to create our string. So we'll imagine here that we're looking at the first row. And for each row, we're going to pass through the column data 3 times, and I'll show you why. The first time, we're going to create the top section of this string. So that's created the top section of this first row of grid cells. The second time we go through the columns, we're going to create the middle section. And there's our middle section for this row of grid cells. And then the third time, we'll create the bottom section. And so for each pass that we're making, we're appending to this string. And when we get to the end of a section, to get to the new line here, you'll notice that back in the code we're adding a new line. So let's look at that now. And there you can see, so this is our first pass, then our new line, our second pass, another new line, and then our third pass, and the final new line. Now you may have noticed this special case where if the row is 1 and the column is 0, we're going to insert this little star icon for the middle section. And we'll see what that looks like in just a second. And the reason we did this is mainly for show. We just want it to more closely mimic one of the mazes from the maze app. Now these next two functions, make top or bottom section and make middle section, they're what actually looks at the array of bools and determines which kind of string we want to append. So is it a string that contains walls or a string that doesn't contain any walls? Then when we finally make it to the bottom here, we can create our maze in 3 lines of code. Not a bad day's work. So this looks similar to what we saw for the student's plist example. We're creating the path to maze1.plist, and then we're loading this into a dictionary instead of an array, and then we call our function visualize maze with the dictionary that we've loaded from the plist.